10, 9, 8,
are you listening?
7, 6, 5, 4. Damn.
Yo, what up, what up, what's good? It's your boy Ycee, Omar Alaji number one. Ain't nobody better than, and you are watching 10 questions in 10 minutes with your boy Ycee on Arise 360. Let's go.
Is he a chairman or is he on a lot? I can tell that you really, really like you, man. Let him up here and the life.
What I've been to if I wasn't a musician? Definitely football, you know. Football has always been an interest for me, and you know, sadly my family didn't really support me playing football, so I had to, you know, find something else to do, and I ended up doing music. But even to this day, you know, I still play football in my leisure time. So like, I don't know, man, maybe if Nigeria needs me at some point, I'll sign up for the Super Eagles. But yeah, if it wasn't football, I would have been, if it wasn't music, I would have been playing football.
Baby girl, be finer, wearing everything designer. Gucci, Fendi, Prada, baby girl, no girl.
Any past regrets since I started music? A couple, you know, but
I feel like, to be honest, you know, every mistake I've made, or you know, every downside of my career has been part of the journey leading me up to this point. So I don't live my life with regrets, you know. Obviously there are bad experiences that maybe if I had a chance to, you know, I would have done a couple of things differently. But I won't say I have any regrets, because if things happened any differently, who knows, maybe I wouldn't be where I am today. But I think if I'm to consider regrets, you know, I wouldn't have signed that contract. Yeah, that's all I'll say about that. I don't know which one of the contracts it is, but that's my major regret. You know, what I would term as nasty is when some fans are overbearing, you know, like, you've taken a picture, you've taken another picture, you want a video, you know, I've basically done everything you wanted. And the second I said no, you know, these guys were just like, Ycee, you're proud, bro. You know, and I think that just rubbed me off the wrong way. And I actually lashed out this guy. I think this was in Ibadan about 3-4 years ago. And, you know, the way they just said it, like, Ycee, you're proud, bro. And, you know, they had to hold me back, because I'm like, I literally taken like over 10 pictures with you guys each. And because I'm like, yo, no more pictures, and it's like, Ycee, I'm proud. And I don't even know when I even said to them, like, where do you know me from? Like, what if I'm proud on a normal day? You know, why would you do that? So I think what I would term as nasty experiences with fans is when they are overbearing and they're like, oh, Ycee, do this, or Ycee, can you please talk to this person on the phone? You know, such a big fan. Or, oh, say hello to my girlfriend, tell her how much I love her. And I'm like, bro, that's not my job, you know. So yeah, I don't like it. So in case any of my fans are watching this, you know, after the first 3 pictures, it's becoming a chore. So even if I don't say it, you sense to know that I will.
I smoke loud in the Benz. 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 I smoke loud in the Benz.
Putting out my debut album independently, you know, I think this entire album release process has, you know, it's opened my eyes and, you know, exposed me to different sides of the business. And it's not as easy as people think, because it's easy to say, oh, I'm going to put out my album next year, I'm going to put out my album so time, and then when it's actually that time to put out the album, you see that there's a lot of work that goes into it, you know. It's very demanding physically, mentally, financially, in any way you can think of it. And, you know, seeing as I set out on the journey and announced I'm going to put out an album this year, and nearing the time of release, there were so many hurdles I had to face, so many challenges, so many sacrifices I had to make. And, you know, being able to finally be at a point where I can boldly say I released my first album myself, and, you know,
yeah, it's, I think that's my biggest achievement so far. You know, any other thing, that there have been many achievements, but personally for me, putting out this album on my own, you know, independently, has been a major milestone. So yeah, my first album, Ycee vs. Zaheer, is a major achievement. How has my relationship been with SA artists since the attacks? Well, I think, you know, it's been like the people that are my guys are still my guys. You know, my friends are still my friends, and we all share the same, I think we all share the same grievances, because it's not a situation that anybody's happy about. You know, nobody wants to be in the position where, oh, you know, your people are getting attacked in my country, or my people are attacking your people. And I think the entire xenophobia situation was, to a certain extent, blown out of proportion, because there was a lot of misinformation going on, a lot of fake news and all that. And, you know, I, like, the entire time any and everything was going on, because of how vocal I was about it, you know, people on the other side of the map were reaching out to me, and, you know, it was a conversation on both sides. So, you know, my relationship, I'm still cool with who I'm cool with, and even more, like, I've been able to create more relationships with other artists as well. So it's not a situation where, because of that, my ties or my relationships with other people, you know, suffered. So everybody wants peace at the end of the day. So, you know, I can boldly say that, you know, my relationship with South African artists that are my guys are still my guys. So, yeah. Would I perform an essay if I was invited? Yes, I would, you know, as long as, like, security is guaranteed, you know. I've been in essay, you know, a couple of times in the past, and I haven't experienced any sort of, you know, violence or whatever. Not to say that, you know, it hasn't happened to other people, but, you know, I personally haven't experienced any of these, and I hope not to at any time. So, like, if there's ever any time or ever any situation where I'm called on to perform in South Africa, I definitely would, you know, make that appearance. So, yeah. I'm a monster, then I wake up, eat pasta. You a slave, meet your master. I'm a king like Mufasa. Ooh, ha, ha. Mikasa, Sukasa. Why did it take me a while to drop an album? I think, you know, like I said earlier, you know, an album project is not something that you easily embark on if you're not ready for it. So, you know, I think after putting out my first EP to test the waters, you know, I was ready to put out an album the following year, but, you know, due to certain circumstances and, you know, more important pressing issues I had to attend to, you know, the album had to wait until I was done with that. And the second I was free of those obligations, the next thing that was on my radar, on my itinerary, was to drop the album. And, you know, that's why it took so long. And a lot of people were actually surprised when, you know, when I say, oh, Ycee vs. Zaheer is my first album, they're like, really, don't you don't have an album? I'm like, yeah, I don't. You know, so it's a decision that I had to be sure that I was ready to embark on. And, you know, seeing as the album is doing well so far, I'm glad I was able to take the step when I was ready for it. In a nutshell, Ycee vs. Zaheer is an album about my two musical personalities, Ycee being the identity for the singing side and Zaheer being the identity for the rapping side. And, you know, it's just a show of diversity and versatility for me, because being an artist that raps and sings at the same time equally as well as I do the other, I always had that at the back of my mind, you know, whenever I wanted to release an album, it was always going to be split between rapping and singing, because, you know, it would be sort of a disservice to, you know, fans of both sides if I put out my first album and it is just one-sided. So, you know, subsequently, in the future, there will be, you know, dedicated rap projects and dedicated singing projects, but I think it was very important for me to make this first album, you know, the best of both worlds. And that's pretty much what I was aiming to, you know, that's the message I was trying to pass across at the end of the day.
Bring it back one time. time. I still love the Benz.
Plans for 2020. Make some more money, make some more money. Yeah, I mean, branch out, you know, explore other areas of entertainment, because, you know, I feel like I have a lot more to offer the entertainment industry and I haven't even begun to scratch the surface. So I think 2020 will see me doing a lot more filmmaking, a lot more, you know, fashion inclined projects. Definitely music is still number one at the end of the day. And yeah, you know, I'm going to be going on tour. So yeah, I mean, I really got, 2019 has been a long year. So, you know, I'm ready for 2020. I'm very ready for 2020. So come rain, come shine all day, all night, I'll be by your side. Yeah, I see my game vexed. Oh, baby, make you tell I'm way fast. You don't know that we be. What would I change about the music industry if I had my way? All these blogs, you know. JustNiger.com, NigerLoaded.com, whatever.com that are illegally distributing music that they shouldn't be doing, and, you know, depriving the artists and the creatives from a large amount of income, you know. So if I could in any way create an alternative for, you know, the consumers and the fans that feel like that is the best way for them to consume music without putting money in the pockets of the creatives, I definitely would address that ASAP. Like, even if it's a situation where, you know, we have to clamor for, say, better internet packages, or, you know, just more channels for the consumer to be able to receive that music without feeling like you have to download it free, because anywhere else in the world, it is illegal to do such. So I just hope someday, somehow, hopefully during my lifetime, that we see an end to these illegal distributors of music. So yeah. You always wrong, you can't be right. I said you just should pass the light. I'm on your chick, should pass the night. She roll on for me. I be on that with shit, don't talk for me. Know they beat around the bush, mole on for me. And if you tryna understand, hold up for me. Baby girl, be finer. Wearing everything designer. Yo, what up? It's been a blast, and you know, I had fun with my 10 questions in 10 minutes on the Rise 360. It's still your boy Ycee Omar Alaji, number one, new school Jagga band, ain't nobody better than. Make sure to check out my debut album, Ycee vs. Zaheer, available on all sites, all streaming and music sharing sites. Don't download it illegally, if not, I'll come for you. But yeah, thank you. I smoke loud in a Benz. 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 So you know I gon' shine like a jeweler. I'm up in your medulla. On the track, I'm a king, I'm a ruler. And I'm out of this world, Luna. Look, I bust for the whole day. I go mad on the track, that's road rage. I do this till I'm out of reach your day. Mafia, we should look him when we don't play. Nah. 10, 9, 8, are you listening? 7, 6, 5, 4, 3.